When Poco introduced the F1 back in 2018, it turned a lot of heads. Sure, it wasn't a completely premium device on the outside, but it had all of the trappings of a flagship phone at the time on the inside. Now Poco is back with a slightly different strategy. Put their brand on an existing sibling brand device. Even if the coat of paint looks and even feels very similar, the company might be looking at a hit with a phone that they are actually now labeling a flagship killer. This is Pocket Now, and I'm Joshua Vergara. What's going on, everybody? This is the Poco F2 Pro. Now, before we get started, allow me to remind you that Pocket Now has a podcast. I serve as the host of the Pocket Now Weekly, with episodes coming out every single week via every podcasting app. Links are in the description below, so join us for discussions on the weekly. See you there. Now, I'm sure many of you will bring up this detail, so let's start off with it. Yes, this seems like a phone we've seen elsewhere before. As Xiaomi continues to grow and have plenty of brands underneath their umbrella, it's equal parts surprising and understandable that very similar design cues would blend together. The Poco F2 Pro looks pretty much like a carbon copy of the Redmi K30 Pro, but I don't find that to be a bad thing for one particular reason. Poco will reach some markets that Redmi doesn't. Case in point, here at Pocket Now and even over at JV, we don't even have the Redmi phones, do we? So this is how I get to try out this smartphone package, so I'm happy to get it one way or another. I have the shiny white edition. It's not glass on the back, but it is shiny nonetheless. The camera module up top is a point of contention for some. It's a circle housing four lenses. The tiniest bit of color flourish is found in the red power button, which is appreciated, and I enjoy that there is a clear plastic case included in the box. Notice, however, that the top of the case has a substantial cutout. This is because the F2 Pro comes with a feature that I've been dying to see come back in 2020, a pop-up camera. I loved how weird phones were getting in 2019 with cameras like this. And in a sea of 2020 punch hole cameras, we finally get a little bit of weird back in our smartphone lives. Poco did not skimp on making it flashy, as there are LEDs in the actual module to make it light up and grab your attention. There are even sound effects and on-screen color effects that add to the experience. And while there is an in-display fingerprint reader, the novelty of the pop-up for face unlock never gets old. Now, up top, there are a couple of other features I'm sure some of you will be really happy to see. A headphone jack and even an IR blaster. These are two things that I don't use as often these days, but it's great to see how the Poco F2 Pro finds ways to marry two different worlds together. The flagship daily experience, and then features that you only see nowadays in mid-range phones. And for that matter, the phone ultimately looks and feels really nice. The phone's not shy about showing itself off. The pop-up camera means that the screen is an unencumbered viewing experience. Now, this is a full HD plus resolution display at 60Hz, putting it behind other displays that are either quad HD resolution, high refresh rate, or both. But as comments over on my unboxing video at JV seem to indicate, many of you are really not affected by this spec. And rightfully so. For the vast majority of people who are looking at this phone as a value prospect, it would have been nice to have the extra features, but it doesn't mean that this phone is any less capable. Otherwise, this is a full screen 6.67 inch AMOLED display. And the fact that it is AMOLED is a further plus because it gives the F2 Pro a great and highly customizable always-on display. Alright, so that pretty much covers everything about the outside, so let's see what powers it all. The story here is very familiar and thus pretty easy to enjoy, in all honesty. The Snapdragon 865 gives this phone the current specs and 5G capabilities, even though I don't really get 5G on Google Fi. Speaking of, there is a liquid cooling system, just like from the Poco F1, to keep things from getting too hot during heavy tasks like gaming. But in general, the daily experience has been on par with the competition despite regional differences. My model is the 6GB RAM and 128GB storage option. I mentioned biometrics already with the in-display fingerprint reader and the pop-up camera, but then we can talk about the battery. It's a sizable 4700 mAh unit that definitely got through full days of work and play. The battery can be charged up quickly at 30 watts or via Qualcomm's Quick Charge 4.0. There's no wireless charging, however, which is honestly a little bit of a bummer. Another small bummer is MIUI, or MIUI. Don't get me wrong, I like how far this software has come, and with the Poco-specific launcher, it does bring a lot to the table. Now, like many Asian Android interfaces, however, there are a few too many additions that might end up collecting dust. Mi-branded apps, for example. Not to mention all of the games that were pre-installed for some reason. And while we all know Xiaomi makes a sizable chunk of money from its services and ads therein, seeing an ad for another app on the very screen where you are installing an app is always odd. Despite some bumps in the road, the Poco F2 Pro is hitting all the right marks and being a flagship device. So is the camera the same story? Well, in a nutshell, yes. But it says more about the current landscape of smartphone cameras than it does about this phone's usability. You see, these days flagships have to get really crazy with their 100x zooms and their built-in gimbals to be considered high level. Meanwhile, the quality level that might actually be used on the daily here is more achievable than ever. Phones at sub $500 are making that happen, and the Poco F2 Pro is a snapshot of that phenomenon, a high-powered main sensor with a few friends to back it up. The 64 megapixel main sensor is a good performer, especially at the pixel binned 16 megapixel results. Colors could use a little bit more punch and the dynamic range is decent, but in all but lower light situations, pictures are plenty usable for social media and messaging. And in those lower light scenarios, there is a night mode, but it doesn't seem as aggressive as one we've seen in other competitors. There's a significant dip in the megapixel counts of the other lenses, but they all put out some good results still. There's the 13 megapixel ultrawide, which can still be used for 4K video recording, and then there is the 5 megapixel macro lens that puts out better quality results than many of its competitors that come in at like 2 megapixels. You can even do macro video, but you tell me if macro is ultimately useful in your daily smartphone life. And finally, there's a 2 megapixel depth sensor for portraits. Speaking of portraits, the 20 megapixel pop-up front-facing camera does a fine job for stills, but only records up to 1080p resolution video. Speaking of, video is an endeavor the Poco reaches for but doesn't quite excel at. AI 8K recording is nice to have, but it's still not a practical format for most people to shoot with. At 8K, it seemed the autofocus was having some issues and stabilization was far less reliable, leading me to stick to 4K throughout. Some Xiaomi-inspired additions are here, like the movie frame, which adds black bars at the top and bottom of any video. Also, there's a vlog mode that guides you in the shot collection and automatically adds the transitions and music for a stylized end result. If you've been paying close attention to phones that are really trying to get under the $100,000 price point, all of this is going to sound familiar, and that's not a bad thing because it means good, even if not overachieving, camera quality is available to just about anyone now. It's not the best shooter out there, but the value prospect fits the results. So as Poco has decided to co-opt the phrase flagship killer, I think that the F2 Pro manages to find itself among plenty of flagships in the market today, with great performance and a good camera experience, a sum of its own parts that easily overshadows the few flaws it does have. But as phones like this continue to be released, we have to start asking the question of what a flagship really means right now, halfway into 2020. Maybe we can put it this way. If you prioritize the S20 Ultras and the P40 Pros of the world, this phone is no killer, but it does help make available the right stuff in the hands of more people. Carbon copy rebrand or not, Poco is making good on their impression as a maker of affordable flagship devices. It's a trend we're happy to see more and more of, and at around $500, hopefully this template continues to redefine the flagship experience so that more and more people can enjoy it. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this review of the Poco F2 Pro. This is an exciting device because it's the return of Poco to a more flagship level. It's available in many more markets, and even if it does feel a little bit too familiar, it's still allowing for more and more people to experience high-end specifications with a good amount of features around it. In any case, let me know what you think about the Poco F2 Pro in the comment sections down below. At the very least, drop some likes on this video, and if you're new here, consider subscribing to the Pocket Now channel. We have videos coming out pretty much every single day. And with all of that said, I'm going to go ahead and call it on this one. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in our next video.